people voted, and you and your name got 50% of all the votes. The fans want to see you and Canelo.
It's going to happen, Elie. It's going to happen. It's going to happen. I promise, bro.
I don't doubt it. The question is, does it happen at 60 or 68?
You think he'll go to 60? He can't even make 68.
Canelo? He's fighting at 68.
Oh, I'm talking about David, dude. I'm still on that motherfucker. Yeah, Canelo, I think he's coming back down to 60.
That would be big.
He's still the franchise champion at 60.
You got that power, that water?
He got.
Charlo, by the way, Regis's house had a lot of damages. How's your house in Houston? Any damage in your house?
That is good. It's good. Great, man. Good.
I'm glad to hear that.
Who you going for? You got Adrian Broner?
Yeah, I got Broner. I'm happy to see him back. I've known him for many years. I actually went to see him last week. He said nice things about you and your...
Hey, let's make a bet. Want to make a bet?
Yeah, let's do a bet.
I have to call him.
Let's put a stack. All right, let's put $500. I say Adrian Broner, stop him. I don't know what round, but he's going to stop him.
Well, I'm going for Broner, so how are we both going to go for Broner?
You going for Broner?
Of course.
Stop it. You don't think he's going to stop him?
Of course he's going to stop him. He's in his best shape he's ever been. He lost 30 pounds. He's focused. You know Gerald Tucker's with him?
Bet off, man.
I'll bet that Adrian wins by knockout. Let me ask you this. Who do you want to see Tank fight next? Tank said yesterday he's coming back in June and that he's fighting a champ, not at one... Gervonta Davis.
Oh, Tank. Oh. Yeah, he's going to be on my undercard in June.
Who do you want to see him fight?
I don't know, man. Dude, cold. He's starting to show out now. Like, let's put the money on him.
A lot of...
Big time gambling, man.
Charlo, what should fans know about you? Like, who is Jermall Charlo?
They know I'm with the shits. All my fans know I'm with the shits. They know I ain't scared of nobody. My fans know we're the real champion. Like, the people who really love me, they know why I fight, bro. They know what's up. My real fans, they love me, man. But you get, see, like, it's crazy when you get, like, a whole country and a whole nation against you. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm beating Russia. You know what I'm saying? Beat the Russian, beat the Ukrainian, you know what I'm saying? Got the Mexicans talking shit about me. Some Americans, they talk shit too. But, you know, people who love me, they know I fight.
You know what's crazy? Your last fight, a lot of people didn't give you a chance. They doubted you. And you made it look easy, like no problem.
It was easy. It was. I promise it was easy. That fight was easier than Korba. My brother-in-law's. That fight was easy, bro. Styles make matchups. I'm long, I'm rangy. I can fight in the inside, though. You know what I'm saying? So, like, it's crazy because, like, and not only that, I got power, bro.
What about you and Triple G? Would you like that fight?
Oh, I've been asking for that fight for years.
Right now, I think you got him. Easy.
Who?
Triple G.
That's why I don't want him no more. That's why I ain't been talking about him. That's why I haven't been talking about him. Okay.
Charlo, do you have any friends that are boxers? Like, who's your best friend in boxing?
My best boxing friend is... I got a few boxing friends, though. I ain't gonna lie. Maybe we all cool. I don't got no best boxing friend, though.
What do you think...
Boxing.
What do you think about Earl Spence and Canelo?
Right here. So we not taking this shit on the plane? Shit, all right, come on. What you saying? Come on, I'm still here.
No, no, I said Errol Spence and Canelo. How big of a fight is that?
Bro, that's not a fight, bro. Like, it's not the same weight division, bro. It's cat. Like, it's not a real fight, bro. Come on, man.
Earl's a big dude, and he spars heavyweights and cruiserweights.
Huh?
Okay, what about this? Crawford and Spence, who you got?
What's that again?
Errol Spence, Terrence Crawford, who wins?
Man, you wanted to get me on here to predict some fighting, bro. Come on, man. They not gonna fight, bro.
You're right.
That ain't even works right now. Give me something in the works. I'll tell you about what's in the works. Something official. Give me something official.
Joshua and Fury.
Joshua and Fury? Joshua.
I got Joshua too. Why Joshua?
I like Joshua. I think his skills, I think he learned on the job, and now he's completed his task things, mastered what he's good at. Man, what a drop at, man. What the fuck? These motherfuckers, look, I'm trying to tell you, they love you in Mexico, but y'all stop playing on me, man.
Okay, Charlo, what would it take for your next fight to be in Mexico? Your next fight in a stadium out there?
I know, man. I'm working on it. It's going to just take a good stadium out here and, something to fill up, man.
When you were a kid, did you...
Yeah.
Charlo.
Yeah,
did he bring it up? Everybody bring it up.
What you said?
When you were a young kid, did you ever think you'd be a boxing star, one of the best fighters in the world, be a champion?
Never, bro. I just worked. My daddy made us fight, and I hated it because I was a football player at first. I always wanted to be in the NFL, and I always wanted to be a NBA star or some shit. I'm a real athlete, you know what I'm saying? I'm a good, I can dive, you know what I'm saying? I can swim. I'm a real athlete, dog. I used to be into everything when I was a kid, but I never thought I'd box.
I've never seen you. I've never seen you out of shape. You and your twin, you're always with a six pack.
Right now, I'm telling you, I haven't stopped working, bro. Right now, what are you talking about? I'm out here. You know what I'm saying? Right now.
No, that's awesome. Most fighters between fights balloon up 30, 40 pounds over their weight. They enjoy life. You're very disciplined.
No, I gotta work because, I didn't start hurting. Hey, hold on, I'm on the phone real quick.
You gotta go?
No, I'm good. I couldn't hear you. I didn't know you asked me a question.
Yeah, I said you're very disciplined. Is there anything you love to eat that right now you're sacrificing and you never touch?
Nah, I can eat whatever I want right now. I don't eat pork, but I can eat whatever I want. I don't eat pork.
Yeah, I don't eat pork either. I never had pork, so I don't know what it tastes like.
Me either.
That's the key.
My homie was telling me, he eat po' chops. I never even know what a po' chop is. Huh? You feel me? What else you want to know, though? I eat whatever I want. I'm still disciplined, but I don't eat, that. I just eat stuff I like to eat.
Let me ask you this. When I first met you guys way back when, you used to have an NBA star who used to come to your game. He was from the Houston Rockets, tall guy.
He used to come to my game?
Your fight, sorry.
Yeah.
What was his name?
Rashard.
Yep. How did you guys team up with all these celebrities from day one?
Rashard is from my city. He's from my city. He's from my town. We from the same town.
Yeah, but NBA stars don't come out to support like that, even if they're from the same town.
You see, bro, you know how real I am. You know what I'm saying? They fuck with the real, man. Everybody fuck with the real.
People like real.
They like real. They like this interview we had.
Okay, Mayweather.
It's going to be all over YouTube.
Yeah, why not? Check this out. Floyd Mayweather is celebrating his birthday this weekend. What are you wishing for his birthday?
He's going to have them hoes out there. Where he's celebrating that bitch at?
Miami. The whole city's going to come out.
Shit, we headed to Miami. I got to go to Toronto. Then I'm going to go to Miami.
What are you wishing for his birthday?
What I wish Floyd Mayweather for his birthday? Shit, good health. I just wish he stay healthy. I wish he get all his hair back. I wish he grow braids. He might even look cool with dreads. Remember his daddy had dreads? I wish you'd give me a car. What else you wish Floyd Mayweather to do? I mean, hell. Fuck. Yeah, he just gave his grandson a rollie and shit. I mean,
you saw
my uncle, dog.
He's a great person. He's a very nice guy. You ever had a good talk with him? He's very smart.
I just told you Floyd my uncle, bro. Uncle Floyd. Call Floyd anytime.
He's cool. He's a good dude.
Yeah.
So let me ask you this. You and your brother, you and your twin are really nice, very cool individuals. Why do people all so negative? What's the reason? I don't understand it. Jealousy?
No, it ain't no jealousy. They just don't know, bro. Like, people just don't know it, you know what I'm saying? Like, you gotta really, I talked to you before in person, you know what I'm saying? People just don't know. I don't care about jealousy. I don't care about, like, none of that, bro. You know what? I got love, like, I get love every day. Like, oh my God, bro. I got 5 kids and they love me. So I don't give a fuck if none of y'all love me. You know what I'm saying? I don't go to sleep thinking y'all don't love me, man. Y'all gotta grow up and like get to reality. The real thing is reality. None of y'all even matter to me.
Would you want any of your kids? Would you want any of your kids to be boxers?
One of them, two of them, like really got a lot of potential in it. I got a daughter, and she not gonna box. Everybody don't. You know what I'm saying? I don't want them to box, but if they want to, they can do whatever they want.
They'll be basketball players and football players.
Yeah, my kid's real smart. I got a 12-year-old. He's driving already.
Can't say that.
Nah, he's driving already. I'm with him. As long as I'm in the car with him, I ain't doing nothing wrong.
That's true. So, Charlotte, what advice do you have for amateurs or young fighters right now that want to be where you are, that want to have that championship, that want to be successful?
Just never give up. Never give up. Amateur fighters, y'all never give up. And look. Don't listen to what nobody say. Like, just you keep striving to be the best you can be. That's all. Just strive to be the best you can be.
And that's awesome. That's coming from the world champion, 31-0.
For real, just strive to be the best you can be. Man, my daddy made me fight. My daddy made us fight. We have no choice. And I end up being a boxer. So whatever you're doing, you can honestly be great at it. You got to spend a lot of time in it.
And the thing is, it's one thing to be a boxer. It's another thing to be undefeated. There's a lot of pressure. Another thing to be a champion. Another thing to make a lot of money. Because if you make a lot of money, you have a lot of new friends, a lot of new cousins. A lot of people want stuff when they see you. They look at you like a walking ATM sometimes. Not. So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, @EliSeckbach.